We're just 2 weeks away from the Cattlemen District Convention and NCBA trade show in Nashville, Tennessee. This can't-miss event has been going strong for more than a century. The first one was held right here in Denver back in 1898. Joining us now to provide more insight in the work that takes place at the annual convention is NCBA CEO Colin Woodall. Colin, folks may not realize just how critically important this meeting is, the future direction of the beef cattle industry. Tell us about some of the work and the business that goes on during this meeting.
Most of the time when you're talking about our convention, you're talking about the fun that we have. Yeah. But you're exactly right, Kevin. This is also where the business of the association takes place. And that's why this is such a critical meeting, because we're going to allow our cattle producers, our members, to come together and give us direction on where they want to take the association. So our policy committees will be meeting, and they're going to talk about everything from waters of the United States to cattle markets to the next farm bill. They'll determine if our policy book is up to date and current and covers everything that we need to, and if not, they'll make some changes. And once they vote on it, once all the members have a chance to vote on it, it's when we as the staff take it and try to achieve everything that they've laid out for us. It's really the fundamental part of NCBA as being a true grassroots, producer-led, and producer-directed organization.
You mentioned cattle markets. It's sure to be a topic in the hallways and the meeting rooms of this convention. Update us on what NCBA has done thus far and what we should expect in the weeks and months ahead from NCBA relative to the state of the cattle markets.
Well, it was just a short year ago where we were having the discussion within the live cattle marketing committee about our new plan moving forward, and that was the 75% plan that we were able to put together. We started measuring against that plan on January 1st, and what we found out is in the first quarter, we failed to meet all of the expectations of our plan. But I'm happy to announce that as we have evaluated the second quarter data, we found out that we passed. So we did not trip our triggers. And when you go back and you look at our policy, it says we have to trip two consecutive quarters before we're forced to go back and look at what next steps we're going to take with Congress. So this is a great sign that, one, our project is working, that we are seeing the result of more cash trade and therefore more price discovery. And it will give us the opportunity to talk about those results in Nashville without the pressure of having to come up with some sort of congressional action to try to support the next steps. That may come down the line, but right now we are showing a lot of great progress on our project.
But again, your point is clear, is that if you want to have a voice, it is important to be at that meeting to make certain that voice is heard. Is that fair?
The whole reason we've been successful, the whole reason that we went towards looking at more cash trade is because of the engagement of NCBA members. If it hadn't been for the members showing up to the business meeting last summer, we would not have had this direction. And what's great about it is it's truly the direction that was placed in our hands by the members. This wasn't my decision. It wasn't the decision of the staff. Mm-hmm. Our job is to implement the decisions made by our members.
Fair statement. Let's talk about another issue. We heard a couple of weeks ago that USDA will be reviewing its country of origin labeling rules. What is NCBA's policy on this, and how do you see this topic as we move forward?
Well, we have long believed that labeling has a role within our industry, especially voluntary labeling, and labels that are divided up a lot of times in terms of state-based labels, regional labels, different marketing claims. So labeling is very important as long as it's true to what the label says. What we know is that the Food Safety Inspection Service has a document that says any product that is processed in a U.S. facility, regardless of where it originated, can be claimed as product of the United States. Even more concerning, however, is that USDA and the Food Safety Inspection Service has no record of who's using that claim. So we are very simply saying we need to have more accountability for this, and instead of saying product of the U.S., let's make it reflect what it truly is, and that's processed in the U.S. Still a voluntary component, and if we want some U.S. labeling claims, state labeling claims, or regional labeling claims, let's go to the Ag Marketing Service and ask them to help us with a process verified program, PVP. That way we know it's auditable and we can prove to the consumer that that label means what it means.
Yeah, it has some teeth to it. You know, we thought we put WOTUS to bed, right? Waters of the United States. It has reared its ugly head once again. What are your thoughts relative to this WOTUS issue, the 30-30 plan, and other priorities of the current administration?
One of the concerns that we always have is just how dead is an issue. And in Washington, D.C., issues are never dead. They can always come back and become zombie issues to some extent. And that's what we're seeing with waters of the United States. It's no surprise that President Biden and his team want to reevaluate this because it's a hot topic. Many lawsuits out there regarding waters of the United States. So it's natural that they would want to review this and put their own spin on it. I think one thing that everybody who's watching right now needs to understand is there's no final decision that's been made on this. So we as NCBA, we're already at the table talking to the administrator, talking to USDA, talking to the White House directly, saying let's not repeat the mistakes of the Obama era rule. We've learned a lot of lessons. We know that we can craft a rule that protects both water quality and private property rights. We were able to do that under President Trump. I still think we could preserve a lot of that in this next iteration of Waters of the United States, but we are on point and we are making sure that they do not take this and write a rule that's going to make it harder for us to stay on the land.
That's fair. Sustainability. Can't open a magazine, read an article, look at the internet without seeing something about sustainability. What's your read on this topic? Where are we at in the beef industry?
Yeah, hot topic. Everybody's talking about it. The consumer's talking about it. Retailers are talking about it. President Biden is talking about it. What that means is it's an opportunity for us. I think for too many years, people have seen sustainability as just another set of rules or regulations being placed upon them, more red tape. That's not the way that NCBA sees it anymore. We see it as a way to demonstrate all the great work that cattle producers are doing today, and that as an industry, we have improved over time and we will continue to improve over time. So we are a part of the solution. We're not part of the problem. And the best part about that is that we are sitting at the table once again with President Biden and his team, making that case, and they're buying into it. So this is going to be an opportunity for us. You know, we're going to have to fight them on things like Waters of the United States. But when it comes to sustainability, this is an opportunity for us to showcase our work rather than just having more rules and regulations placed upon us.
And speaking of opportunities, one of the bright spots in our industry is this beef demand. It's been phenomenal and red hot over the last year, both domestically and internationally. And convention provides an opportunity for us to gather together and actually have some committee work being done relative to beef demand building. What will happen in Nashville relative to keeping the fires hot under beef demand?
So the checkoff committees are all going to get together and they're going to talk about the work that the checkoff does as a whole, but it's also an opportunity for us as a contractor to the beef checkoff to showcase the work that we do with the Beef It's What's for Dinner brand and all of the great success that we've had this past year. As you mentioned, demand is red hot. We are cleaning out meat cases even today. And every time that we think that the consumer is about to trail off, we're surprised again. And that's a great problem for us to have as an association. And I think a lot of it is tied to just how successful that checkoff funded Beef It's What's for Dinner promotion work has been. We have a very robust summer grilling season going on right now. We're on the Food Network with broadcast ads, and it's reminding everybody that we are the protein of choice when it comes to the summer. We're the protein of fun, and we're going to be able to showcase that in Nashville.
That's a great way to wrap us up. Colin, it's going to be a fun week. It's going to be a busy week. We look forward to seeing you there. Thanks for coming to the show.
Thank you, Kevin.